After nearly a decade of near silence, St. Hubbins, Tufnel, and Smalls reunite.
You won't behave the way a big girl should. It's time to give that whip a crack.
Like the Wind, the historic new album from Spinal Tap. Available now on MCA Dead Faith compact discs and Hi-Q cassettes.
Good girl.
My next guest, a true legend in the world of rock and roll, heralded as the loudest band in the world, performing the majesty of rock from their album Break Like the Wind. This is Spinal Tap.
Newborn sun, a beat in the heat of noon. There's a song as the day grows long, and the tempo rises of the moon. It's all around us and it's everywhere, and it's deeper than royal blue. And it feels so real, you can feel the feeling. And that's the majesty of rock, the fantasy of roll. Ticking of the clock, the wailing of the soul, the prisoner in the dark, the digger in the hole. We're in this together and ever. The shade of a jungle glade, all the rush of the crushing street. On the plain, on the pony lane, escape from the beach. It's in the mud and it's in your blood, and its conquest is complete. And all that you can do is just surrender to the majesty of rock, the pageantry of roll, the crowing of the cock, the running of the bull, the shepherd with his flock, the miner with his toll. We're in this together.
For the heck of it, I have some older fans. Why don't you introduce yourselves?
My name is David St. Hubbins.
Thank you.
Yeah. Next. I'm Derek Smalls.
I'm Nigel Tufnel. Was it loud enough?
Oh, gosh. You know, we're going to get to that. We're going to get to that.
What?
But let me start with the title of the album. How did you title the album, and how has this album changed from the previous one?
You mean Break Like the Wind?
Yes.
Well, it's a bit of irony, really, because the wind, as you might guess, it doesn't really break, does it?
It bends.
It flows. It warps.
Yes.
Yeah. So it's sort of ironic. It's like saying, you know, shine like the night.
Or the,
you know, it don't really shine, does it?
Or the, shine like the dust.
Shine like the dust.
Shine like the
yeah,
dust.
Yeah, yeah. Which is a better title now.
It is.
Think about it.
It's a little light, though.
It is.
Yeah.
And how is Break Like the Wind different from the previous album?
Well, we did it during the 80s and 90s. Whereas the previous albums we did mostly during the 70s.
60s and
60s, yeah.
But digital, this is all digital. This is all digital, and it really, this is the first album in which we've allowed, we didn't say we can't do this tune because that's not tap, you know, because it's not loud enough to be tap, or it's not rough enough to be tap.
Yeah.
We let ourselves be all the Spinal Tap we could be.
It's part of the new maturity we find ourselves trapped in.
Yes. Well, I just figured out why I couldn't hear you.
Why?
Well, I've got these things in my ear.
Oh, you've got to get them out. You know,
very weird.
For the chat segment, you take those out.
Yeah, take those out, yeah.
Well, actually, okay, we should get to the volume. You need those. And people say you're the loudest band in the world, and it seems like it's getting louder.
What?
They say you're the loudest band in the world.
It seems like it's getting louder.
Yeah, it is.
You're getting louder as you get closer, you know. So it's a lot of that going around,
I guess. Our theory, really, is that, you know, there's this kind of music called jazz. You've probably heard of it. And the thing about jazz is they play very quietly. It's like... And it's, what are they afraid of?
Yeah, what are they ashamed of?
Turn it up!
Yeah, turn it up. I think it's because they make so many mistakes in jazz. And then, you know, jazz is really constructed entirely of mistakes when you really think about it.
Oh, I wanted to do this
anyway. Yeah, I meant to do that.
Oh, sure. Yeah, it was originally supposed to be a 13th chord.
Yeah, right.
No, it was supposed to be C major. Oh, but yeah, it was like C with a flatted fifth.
Yeah,
sure.
Yeah, right.
Yeah,
yeah.
Right. Yeah.
Like they could play that.
So we're loud because we've got nothing to be ashamed of, really.
Yeah.
We're loud because we're proud.
Yeah. Yeah, you know, I don't want to get into negative things, but Gloria Steinem was here recently. And, she was right here,
actually. She was so great in Sunset Boulevard, though.
No,
you know, that's Gloria Swanson,
right, yeah.
Gloria Steinem is a feminist,
and
a lot of feminists around the world are very upset about bitch school.
I'm sure you've heard about it.
Yeah, this is a mistake. I mean, it's not a mistake that we made the record. It's a mistake because the song Bitch School is about training dogs. You see, we love dogs,
simple.
And it's about dogs. It has nothing to do with women at all.
Yeah.
There's a woman on the cover of the single with a leash around her neck, but that's just for... to get your attention.
That's marketing.
That's marketing.
That's not sexism.
That's just smart business, you know.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Smell the glove. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Big fans.
Yeah. Yeah.
Guys, we should talk about drummers.
Oh, yeah. Definitely today, yeah.
Yes.
No, we have had some rock. This looks like Stonehenge, doesn't it?
It really does. Can we borrow this?
Sure.
It's a bit larger than Stonehenge.
Yeah.
But,
and softer.
Yeah, right, yeah.
Softer Stonehenge going.
Yeah, we've had some bad luck with drummers. We call it, it's really a curse. We've lost 12 drummers.
We're on number 13.
Don't tell him he's number 13.
No, you know. Might worry him, yeah.
Yeah. One of your drummers blew up, right?
Two.
Yes. Two blew up.
Two, yeah. And the keyboardist blew up, but he had been a drummer previously.
He was visiting the grave to pay his respects, and he blew up.
The grave blew up.
Yeah.
You know, they were all
it's
happy.
It's a curse. Yeah, it's really a curse.
Yeah, do you mind, your manager asked me not to talk about this, but could we talk about the cucumber in the foil paper?
Oh, that's his job. Yeah.
Well, yeah, but I should, you know, say...
Again, that's marketing.
Straight.
More than anything else.
Well, let's explain this, because some people might not have...
Well, you're on stage. Everything's bigger than normal on stage, right? You know, I mean, people do eye makeup and they have oversized instruments of various sorts, and that's all I do.
Trouser makeup.
I have trousers.
Yeah.
An oversized trouser instrument.
Right, yeah.
It's sort of like trouser helper.
Yeah. But I do have to point, because people ask me this all the time, it's not a cucumber. because if you think about it, a cucumber would defeat the purpose because its surface is sort of pimply and people would go, oh, there's something wrong there, you know.
Yeah, very
so
well,
it's
yeah.
a zucchini.
Yeah.
It's a zucchini.
And it's certainly less painful than the collagen.
Yes, it is.
Yes.
You know, you probably, I mean, it's probably unfair to you that they've singled you out. I mean, aren't there other musicians who put things in their pants?
Well, it was our idea. It wasn't his idea.
No.
They just said,
see,
you know,
we were watching him one day, you know, on a video, and we went,
no, something's missing, Dale.
Yeah, something's definitely missing.
Yeah.
What should we do?
You're not giving him their money's worth.
I said special lenses might help. But,
no,
you know.
No.
No, and he jumped on it right away, so,
yeah.
you know.
Well,
well not literally.
I slipped it in. Jumped on it on my own time. Yeah.
Everybody knows that rock and roll is synonymous with groupies. Are ladies ever disappointed when they get to the hotel room with you and find out it's a zucchini?
Would they you like us to leave the room?
They never get that far. No.
No, they have their choice.
One big family, you know.
One big black leather metallic family.
Yeah, the leads, but like I said before, you know, I didn't want to blow these other blokes away, you know. I've been doing this a lot longer than they have, you know. I've got pipes I haven't used yet.
He could break the board.
I haven't located them yet.
He could break the board in there, you know.
Yeah,
it's really, it's an act of mercy to the engineers that he doesn't sing lead.
The Malmsteen person, you know, and once you get the hang of his name, you know, he's really incredible. I really did. I bought his album the other day, and I threw my guitar out. I said, why bother? Why bother, you know? Use it as a coffee table, you know, because I can't play the thing like that. He's great. I like the way he puts Yngwie J. Malmsteen on his album, so you know, you don't confuse him with all the other Yngwie Malmsteen in the business. Oh, yes. Sounds a bit like rock and roll, doesn't it?
Hello.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello.
Les, you wearing any kielbasa links under there?
I wouldn't look under either. I was in Scotland one time when a guy just lifted up one of those kilts.
Yes, and you just happened to be there.
Oh, yeah. Boy, were we out of there in a hurry?
Yeah. It's Loch Ness Monster fell out, huh?
All hell broke loose. Forget about it. You don't lift up a kilt, right?
No, you don't let someone else lift it up either. No.
Not even a guitar player, right?
No.
Okay, go ahead.
Oh, look.
I hear you play guitar.
Yes, I do.
You're not familiar with Mr. Tufnel's work?
Yeah.
Well, I will be familiar in a few minutes.
Yeah, you guys are going to jam together. Now, you know, you're a bit of a famous inventor, the multi-track recording and that. You know, Nigel, he of the 11 setting on the amplifier. Are you familiar with that?
Yeah, I heard about it.
Yes.
Well,
the new thing, actually, I have two new things. There's the amp goes to infinity now.
Oh.
So I figure, you know, why limit
sure.
self? And there's also the amplifier capo. It's a capo that goes around an amplifier, and it squeezes the speaker cones like this. And we were playing a gig, and a fat man fell into an amplifier. And the sound changed. And I thought, how can I do that? So it's getting fat. An amplifier capo squeezes it, and the sound goes up, so you don't have to wear a capo.
There you have it, Les. Brilliant.
Brilliant. From an everyday moment. They're going to play together. We'll be right back with Nigel Tufnel, Les Paul, right after this. Here to perform, Sweet Georgia Brown, Les Paul, and Nigel Tufnel. Gentlemen. We'll be right back.
after a very, very long hiatus. This is their brand new album right here entitled Break Like the Wind. It's already an unbelievably huge success. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome one of Britain's loudest bands, Spinal Tap. For a commercial, and then we'll chat with these gentlemen. Come on back, folks. Yeah. Thank you, Ben. Thank you, Paul. Welcome back. Spinal Tap is here. You guys sounded more powerful than I remember you actually sounding.
Really?
Let's talk a little bit about this is your brand new album.
Yeah, it's a CD, actually.
Oh, yeah, CD. Yeah.
No, I mean, you could call it an album. We've never had a CD before.
Congratulations.
It's been 8 years.
We've never been digital.
No.
And the name of the song we heard, I guess, was Bitch School.
Bitch School.
Are there some controversy with that song?
Yeah, it's nonsense, though. I mean, there's really no reason for it.
Well, some people have said, some women have said that it's...
And men.
That it's offensive. But, you know, they don't realize, if you listen to the words, it's about dogs.
It's all about dogs.
Dog training,
Dog training.
Discipline in the dog world.
Yeah. Well, you know, people... Yeah, of course you do. People hear sometimes what they want to hear,
that's exactly
right. Now, tell me about the cut number 11, Clam Caravan. What is that about?
Oh, that's his. Yeah.
Clam Caravan.
That's a misprint. It's supposed to be Calm Caravan.
There's no clams in the song.
Mention of shellfish of any kind in the song.
It's a typo then. Well, I mean, it won't ruin the album or anything.
No, it's
doing very well for you, isn't it?
Yeah, not badly.
Let's talk a little bit about, has it been 8 years that you guys were apart? How did you get back together? Why did you get back together? How was that?
Well, it's a sad story. I mean,
not really.
They like sad stories. Yeah. They like sad stories.
We met up at the funeral of our manager, mm-hmm. Ian Faith.
Our late. Yeah.
You think that's funny too, don't you?
Yeah.
Well, actually, it was.
And yeah. it was one of the happiest places you've ever seen in your life. Yeah, I mean, for a funeral. Yeah.
No one liked
him. Yeah, laughing, people laughing and jumping around.
What did he die of, exactly?
It was sort of an exploded blood vessel somewhere near his face.
Well, on the coroner... actually, on the coroner's report, it said embezzlement.
Cause of death, embezzlement. Yeah.
So that good feeling from the funeral, uh-huh. we were running by the coffin and flicking his nose. Yeah.
Right. Now, can you give us an idea of what you guys did? Did you were you in music individually? Did you have your own records out? Or what kind of things did you do in those 8 years?
Well, I was managing some local bands back in Pomona, California. Uh-huh. I've been living in California, Southern California. Yeah. Wonderful new trio called Meconium. Watch out for Meconium. They're going to be very hot. Meconium? Next year's Nirvana, yeah. And I've also been teaching soccer to five-year-olds. Right. Almost nothing to do with music. But,
I've been doing some inventing. I've got a little inventing shed in the country.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah. And I've been working on a folding wine glass.
Folding wine glass?
Yes. You see, there are four sides, and they fold down, uh-huh. you see, so you can put it in your pocket. Right. Yeah. Yeah.
So it's perfect for like picnics?
Well, it's not perfect for anything because it leaks.
No, I see. Other than that, and I tell you, Derek, can we chat with you in just a second?
You sure can.
All right, hang on. We'll do a commercial. We'll be right back here with this final. Right, let's see. April 20th, you gentlemen will be performing at Wembley Stadium in London.
Yes.
Yeah, very exciting.
Part of the Freddie Mercury tribute. Yeah, we're doing one song. We negotiated up from no songs. That was their first offer. And
very shrewd. Yeah. I can't begin to tell you how happy I am that you guys could stop by and see us here tonight.
Too.
Good luck. Thank you for being with us.
Very much.
Spinal Tap, ladies and gentlemen. Good night, everybody. Have a good weekend. Bye-bye.
The concert tonight is tomorrow night.
Oh, great. Tomorrow night?
You assured us.
You know what it is?
What?
It's Chinese leap year.
Look, tomorrow
night. And you count an extra day.
Let's go. I can't do it tomorrow night. Tomorrow night, dinner with Marissa.
We'll talk to Marissa.
It's Marissa. This is a tragedy.
Wait a minute. You're not Metallica.
I'm not dressed yet.
What have you done with our hero? Never mind. I'm not that interested anymore.
We've got a bone to pick with these two. You know, it's called
Black Album.
It's called Black Album. Now, where did the idea come from to do an all-black album, Metallica representatives?
To me, it's sort of an underhanded left-wing tribute.
It's an homage dressed up as a...
Or a homage.
As a woman.
Or a homage, yeah.
Dressed up as a woman, yeah.
Yeah.
It was meant as a homage.
Well, I'll tell you something, if it had been a really piss-poor album, then we would have gotten right ticked off, you know.
They would have thought it was
ours. It was a decent album, didn't sell badly, so we figured, we took it as a tribute. No, it's got a great snake. It's got the name of the band on it, too. I mean,
well, I know,
you can't miss. If we had done that, we might have sold more copies.
Well, we can't miss snakes. We're not
them.
And the name Metallica might have helped. Yeah, yeah. Of course, if we could put the name Metallica on our albums, we'd have no problem.
By the way, sorry for mispronouncing it on the MTV Awards, but I was just so flustered.
English was not his mother tongue.
No. My mother's tongue.
Yeah. I'll talk about his mother's tongue, you know, mine.
Yeah. Oh, God, go to the loo again. It makes me think E minor, B, A,
C,
C,
C7.
Although we did not know Freddie Mercury personally, we here in the band, we all love this music very much.
And unfortunately, he wasn't as big a fan of us as we were of him.
And so in his honour, we would like to cut our set short tonight by about 35 songs.
We believe Freddie would have wanted it this way.
Tap. Good to see the boys back in a stadium setting again, isn't it?
As Spinal Tap. Welcome to MTV.
Thank you very much.
Again, gentlemen.
Yeah, nice Thanks, to see Martha. You again.
It's been many, many years.
It really has, yeah.
We have millions of phone calls.
Great.
Why don't we just start right into it, and then I'll just jump in with various questions.
All right. Okay.
Where's the phone?
We'll just hear
that's
it.
That's what these are for.
Oh.
We've got like.
We don't have plugs. To pay for the calls, do we?
No. Okay. It's
and we didn't take down the number you mentioned.
No, that's not. That's right? The other do we get the tapes?
Yeah, the tapes?
Yeah, the ones that are made to stand the heat of the car.
Oh, only if you call in. So if you go out and call in,
we'll
then maybe you can get
call
in the car.
Yeah. Would you run out and call in?
So manager
but
call
for instance, Eric is going to get tapes.
Oh, great. Hello.
And Eric is on the line from Atlantic Highlands, New Jersey. Eric, you are on with the tap. Take your chances.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hello, Eric.
Hello, Eric.
Hey, listen, I just wanted to say I'm a musician, and you guys are my biggest influence. Like, all the stuff you did on, like, Shark Sandwich.
Oh, yeah, thanks, yeah.
Really good stuff.
Yeah. Thanks.
Listen, do you guys plan to work with Artie Fufkin anymore of Polymer Records?
We're not sure where he's not with Polymer anymore. I think he's got an independent label or a promotion firm or something like that.
He was in the wholesale liquor business.
Well, I knew he'd keep his hand somewhere in the rock and roll industry.
He was looking for something sleazier than the record business, and that's all he could find.
He might have hit it, yeah.
In fact, we got to know a lot of people who are involved in your organization from the movie. Off the top of my head comes Bobby Fleckman.
Oh, yeah.
Well, that must have been uncomfortable.
Yeah, she was.
She's. The last I heard, she was working in a coroner's office.
Really?
Yeah.
It's an interesting switch from.
Well, not really. It's not very really, similar. But,
yeah. She helped bury a lot of bands in a time. So.
Yeah.
I see.
Eric.
Eric, thank you very much for the call, and we'll
enjoy
now go to Cincinnati, Ohio. You all have played, I know, of course, documented in Cleveland, Ohio, but John is calling from Cincinnati. Hey, John, how are you today?
All right, great. How you doing, guys?
Hello, John.
How are you?
Great. My question's for Nigel. I was just wondering why you didn't put the song Lick My Love Pump on the new album.
Yeah.
Not done.
It's... No.
No, it's not done.
No, it's not.
Be honest with
no,
you.
No, John, it's really a life's work, you know. I wake up early in the morning, and I put on the kettle. I go and feed my little cat, and I say, here, look, little bit of fish for you.
You're stalling.
What?
You're stalling.
Oh, no. Well,
that's what you're doing when you feed the cat.
Oh, and then I go to the piano and, you know, work out. Basically, the answer is, it's a life thing. It really is never finished, ever. Hello?
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
How much, like this answer. Yes, I have a question.
On this album, but...
Yeah, I have a question for you.
Yeah.
How much do you weigh? Hello?
Excuse me?
How much do you weigh?
Weigh?
Yeah.
160.
That's good.
Close,
good.
Yeah, close, yeah.
So is that good? Does that seem
good? No, he's predicted the weights
of
several of the callers.
Yeah, I can predict people's weights.
Oh, well, here, let's try it again. See if you can predict the weight of Dave, who's calling from Williston, North Dakota. See if you can predict Dave's weight.
Hello, Dave.
Hi, how you guys doing?
Oh, Dave's
fine,
170.
Dave.
Yeah, I was wondering, what inspired you guys to write the song Bitch School, and did you think that censorship would affect it at all?
165.
You think? Well, we have a...
What's your weight, Dave?
No comment.
He's no coward, he says.
At least.
Yeah, there's been some controversy about Bitch School, because people have, you know, taken it the wrong way, obviously. I mean, it was written about... Dogs. I mean,
That's what inspired
dog training.
Us.
It's dog training and
our love of dogs and the.
Well, throughout the show, we are showing pieces of the video which MTV hasn't aired because of its questionable. And it doesn't seem to be about dogs. That's not what's portrayed
well,
in the
no,
video.
See,
so
we
if you're going to write a song
dogs
about
video.
Dogs, no, why do you not make the video so people can be...
Oh, so should videos just spell out all the meanings that are in, or should they expand them and
avoid them?
And avoid them.
Yeah. Yes.
No, we'll tell you the truth. We said we'd like dogs in a video,
right.
And the record company said no one wants to see bloody dogs.
So they want to see dogs. They watch the Discovery bloody channel.
Yeah,
yeah.
Is that the case?
So
it just feels
said,
to me like you're trying to say it's about dogs when
well,
in fact it's really
it.
Not. And I think you should tell the truth and say what it's really about.
You're very combative, you know.
Well,
he didn't used to be. I mean, she likes to fight.
Used to be
you know?
So
she
sweet.
Does. She was very sweet.
What
yeah.
happened to you? You've been embittered.
In fact,
by years,
and I mean this in a nice way. You used to be a pushover, Martha, and we missed that.
I remember when
now
I used to
sucking.
Push you in a stroller.
That was a long
you
time
don't
ago.
You remember that?
I don't?
No.
Oh.
You might have imagined it.
You might have wished it.
Yeah.
Well, I'm wishing
yeah.
it right now.
Yeah, I bet you are.
It's about dogs is the short answer.
Well,
we said dogs in the video. They said, no, how about women? We said, if we must.
So you were pushed into it is what you're saying.
We were what do they call this?
The small of your back.
Compromised.
Yeah.
All right. Well, thank you, Dave, for the call. And I guess I'll just try and kick back and be a little bit nicer throughout.
Yeah.
Christy is calling from Culpeper, Virginia. Hi, Christy. What's your question?
Yeah. Hi, guys.
Hello, Christy.
I saw you on MTV Spring Break. You guys were great.
Oh, thanks.
Thank you. Did you like my trousers?
I did.
Yeah, they were purple and black.
My question is, are you going to have another tour? And if so, when?
Yeah.
Yeah, we're going out in mid-May. Where do you live?
Culpeper.
Yeah. Culpeper, Virginia.
That's near Warrington.
I love Culpeper.
It's near Warrington. It's near Hot Pepper, isn't it?
It's near Warrington?
Yeah, between Warrington and Charlottesville.
We'll try. Do you know Johnny?
No. Don't play that game. She's not going to know that, yeah. What's your question, darling?
We will be on tour throughout the States in beginning in May.
Yeah.
Yeah, but not in...
We're supposed to be playing that Civil War battlefield.
Antietam.
Antietam,
we might be... Live at Antietam.
Christy, you can look for that. Spinal Tap live at Antietam. That will be.
Okay.
Good. Okay, Christy. Thank you.
Thanks, Christy.
And we have Trevor on the line from Kego.
1:15.
Oh.
No. Is that Christy or Trevor? Trevor's
take
a bit.
Take a pick.
Let's hear Trevor's
pick. Kego Harbor, Michigan is where Trevor is calling from. Hey, Trevor, what is your question today?
Hello, guys in Spinal Tap.
Hello, Trevor.
141.
148.
148. Yeah. All right.
Go ahead, Trevor. Just jump on in anytime. Trev.
Oh, we lost Trevor.
Terrified Trevor.
Trevor. He's talking away. We can't hear him.
You can hear him?
Turn up your radio?
Oh, there he is.
Oh, there you are.
Here I am.
There you go.
And the latest cover of Guitar World magazine, Nigel has a very unique looking guitar in the form of a Marshall stack. I was wondering, on the volume control on that stack, does it go up to 11, by the way?
Interesting question.
Do you have the answer?
Oh, yes. Well, basically, my amplifiers, the new ones that you can buy today go to 20, in case you haven't looked in a record shop or an amplifier store. Mine goes now to infinity. It's the little 8 on its side.
Sideways 8.
You keep twisting the dial.
You think it's broken.
It keeps going around and around and around, and you've twisted it maybe 300 times, and you're still not there, but you need that sonic brilliance and capacity that affords me. Hello, Trevor?
Actually, Trevor brought up Guitar World, and I was reading, it says, Tufnel's brilliant two-decade-plus stint as lead guitarist with England's now legendary Spinal Tap has earned him an eternal place in the pantheon of rock guitar legends. Now, Derek and David, I put to you, Derek and David, when you hear something like that, I mean, obviously Nigel's a guitar player, so he gets a lot of this kind of attention. Does that make you feel jealous at all?
No, not at all. No, I feel right chuffed, you know. He's chuffed, proud. Very proud of him.
Well, in the old days, it's like a game of, what do they call it, croquet, really, isn't it?
Not really.
No.
How would that be?
Like a game of croquet, I don't get that.
It kind of goes through the wicket,
that's the word. We're going to discuss this, the toll-free number here to call Spinal Tap, and you can still do it, 1-800-344-ROCK, and that's 7625.
How is it like
our guests are the members of Spinal Tap.
Some people.
Welcome back, Rockline on MTV. My guests today are Spinal Tap. If you have a question, the number, and it's toll-free, is 1-800-344-ROCK. Nigel, I just have to ask you, why do rock and roll guitar players always do that thing with their tongue?
You mean while they're playing?
It's so disgusting. It is. You know what I'm talking about.
That's not what you said last week, was it? You said, why do you tire so easily? You can't just flip it like that when you're on television, can you?
Now, you tell the truth. That's not true. I never said that. Quite like that.
Are we still on?
Yeah. You are.
I see. Hello, Mark.
Mark's gone.
We haven't gone then.
Rock and roll guitar players always do that.
You know what it is.
Girls always go, oh, that's gross.
They don't do that, though.
No,
you
do that.
You do that. You ask other people, like Mr. Edward Van Halen, Mr. Lee. You ask those people, Mr. Lukather, if when they come off stage, what they do. You see if it doesn't work.
Well.
You see if it doesn't work. All right.
When we get a girl on the phone, we'll discuss it.
Yeah, well, what do you mean by that, then?
Well, we have Mark on the phone from Hollywood, Florida.
Well, maybe he's...
Hello, Mark.
He's a guy. He's kind of biased. Hi,
maybe
Mark.
Cross-dressers.
Spinal Tap, how you doing?
All right, good. Mark.
Welcome back to America. I've been waiting for it for years.
Thanks.
So you weigh about 165?
Yeah.
You're right on the money.
Oh, no way. Man.
Amazing. My question is, this is for David in particular, but it goes out to everybody. How do you guys deal with all the groupies that, you know, follow you backstage and pester you and everything? That's got to be a problem.
Well, I deal with them by... my wife has embossed the words married, no children, across my eyebrows when I go out on the road, just to make sure
he's married,
hermetically sealed, so I'm maybe the wrong one to ask. He's the one. He's the bruiser over here.
No. We, basically, you know, Derek and I have a different situation on the road, and we must say that it's important in these days to, you know, be protect yourself, so we double bag it.
And protect paper. One another as well, yeah.
Paper and plastic. Paper and plastic.
Paper and plastic's very important.
Really, and depending on your feelings for the person, which one first, you know.
You do get older, and, you know, things like in the old days, we used to go back to a hotel and, you know, take the telly and throw it out the window, and now we don't have the energy, so we get the groupies to do it, you know. Much less energy.
It's a novelty.
The women
it's a
are
novelty
much better
for them.
Shape than they used to be.
They, they work out, powerful, and it's fresh for them, you know, something new for them. For us, it's interesting to just lay in bed and watch it now. Yeah.
Well, thank you very much, Mark, for the question. Let's move over to St. Louis, Missouri, where Andrew is waiting on the line. Hey, Andrew, what's your question?
Yeah, I was wondering if you guys are planning another documentary, like, on your U.S. tour?
No, you see, what happened last time, we put our lives, we laid our lives bare to the peering eye of an alleged filmmaker, Mr. Marty DeBurgi.
The Butcher.
The Butcher. And he released a very slanted version of our lives, which made us look a bit foolish. So we're once bitten, well, twice bitten probably, but then the third time, I think we'll pass on it. We are planning a television special to revolve around a concert, which and us, a concert we're doing at Royal Albert Hall in July.
Yeah, but so, we're the only ones with a camera around us this time.
It was like being stabbed in the back, you know, and it's. The reason is obviously that people don't want to see good news, you know, a band just going out and everything going smoothly. Yeah. They like to see the bad news. And it's like, I've said it before, it's like newspapers, you don't want to see Siamese kittens born, all healthy. You don't see people rushing down and buying that newspaper. But if they see, you know, Welsh corgi head ripped off, no, they run and read that one.
I know what you're saying, but what's in it for
that?
Marty? What
no, that's not real. It's just
it's a hypothetical
situation.
Corgi's okay.
No, corgi's
there's
fine.
No corgi. It was
there's
just no an example.
But guys, how would Marty have benefited by having you come out looking
if it had been a corgi?
Not as good as maybe you should have? Well, how does that benefit him? Why would he have done that?
Because just what I said, people like to see people made buffoons of.
It's
like the JFK movie.
It's exactly like the JFK movie.
They wound up killing the president.
That's right. It's propaganda. You know, he'd rather deal in propaganda than truth. That's how he benefits.
What is the truth of JFK?
Oh, we don't know.
Oh, we don't know.
Oh, I see.
We've just seen the propaganda.
You see, that's like a Zen, what?
Conan.
Yeah. Where there's no beginning or end. It's like after a rain.
What's the sound of, you know, clapping in the forest after a tree falls? You
right,
know?
Yeah, exactly, right. Yeah.
Okay. Well, we're going to take a break. You're watching Rockline on MTV. Today's guests are Spinal Tap. We'll be right back. David, who's calling from Oak Ridge, Tennessee. David, what is your question today for Spinal Tap?
Yes, I live in a Bible Belt, and all the music stores refuse to sell your tapes and albums. And I was wanting to know how I can inquire how I can go about getting some.
Well, I wonder why they do that. Is it because of satanic content? Because we've tried to cut way back on that.
I mean, Christmas with the Devil is no threat to the Bible Belt.
No,
that's
not
what you're
really.
Worried about.
No.
But I would say that as far as the current album goes, you could probably get in touch with people at MCA. I mean, just write to MCA Records and say, help, I'm in the Bible Belt.
MCA Records.
They'll understand and they'll send you exactly what you need.
MCA Records, Universal City, California. And if you want to see our new video, Bitch School, on MTV, why don't you call 1-800-DIAL-MTV and ask for it, because that's the only way.
And certainly, if the CD was to be in a record store, you couldn't miss it because it's packaged in the extra long box.
Yeah.
Well, that's for environmental purposes.
The idea there was to provide at least 6 inches more recyclable material per album. And that way, we're doing our part.
Because people say, I'd like to go down the recycling center, but I don't have enough stuff.
Really.
Oh, I see.
And they put it off.
So this helps them push it over to the edge, fill up that garage so you can go out and like, take
I
care
see.
Of business.
Just gives you that extra incentive.
Yeah, extra 6 inches,
okay.
That we so often need, don't we, fellas? Yeah.
David, thank you very much for your call. Tiffany is on the line from Baton Rouge, Louisiana.
Hello, Tiffany.
Hello.
Hello, Tiffany.
What's up?
Well,
you are.
Couple of things.
Yeah.
What's your question?
105.
I want to know what y'all thought about girl drummers in a band.
Oh, we had a drummer audition at the Coliseum in Los Angeles, and one of the most erotic sights in my life would be Gina of the Go-Go's and Debbie of the Bangles sharing a drum kit.
And a stool.
For one pass at Big Bottom. Yeah, it was quite remarkable.
Are you a drummer?
I love the drums, but I kind of play around with them, you know. But
yeah. It takes a lot of coordination. Yeah.
No, it's definitely one of the most sexy things to see a good woman drummer.
Yeah.
There was one in Germany a few weeks ago.
Yeah. She sweat a lot.
They usually win our auditions when we have drummer auditions. We usually automatically.
But you have a new drummer.
We've got a new drummer, but he's got a fever.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
You're kidding.
So we need some backup.
Bit dodgy right now. We need backup
and we can...
Can't take solid food at the moment.
So wherever we go, there will be a drummer standing by on a beeper.
I don't know how you get drummers to audition for your band because
they're fearless.
Seat.
They're fearless.
Well, look, drummers, they can count to four and then they've got to start all over. How smart can they be?
With all respect. Phil Collins is a very bright man. I happen to know Phil Collins is bright.
Well, he hasn't auditioned for us.
That's how smart he is. Yeah, exactly.
The jazz guys, it's a little different, you know, because they're playing in 7/8 and, you know, 5/4.
So they can
smarter. About the time while you've got her on the phone.
Oh.
Tiffany.
Are you still there?
I think Tiffany's gone. We're moving on to Terry.
She didn't want to face the tongue issue.
She moved to the Bible Belt.
Terry is from Spark Hill, New York. Terry, how are you?
I'm fine.
Hey,
good, Terry.
Hi, Spinal Tap. You guys are the greatest.
Thank you.
I have just two very, very brief questions for you. Number one, the first question is for David.
Yes.
Are you still seeking spiritual enlightenment? And number two, the second question is for Nigel. Do you plan on doing anything unique with your famous guitar solos on your upcoming tour?
Well, yes, I'm certainly seeking spiritual enlightenment. Why, you got any hints? Because I've tried everything, and enlightenment seems to be eluding me. I'm getting close, though. I'm getting tremors.
No, you're not.
Yeah, I am. No, believe me. That you can measure them now.
You two seem to quibble a lot. Is this a...
No, we've just known each other for
for 30 years. You can't help but quibbling. Yeah. If we weren't quibbling, if there's no friction in a group, then you've got, you know what, the Carpenters or some group like that.
Yeah.
You've got...
There's no friction between those two anymore.
No.
Well, not the group, the Carpenters, actual Carpenters.
No, literally Carpenters, yeah. No, you've got to have, you know, riffs and tiffs, you know. We'll be going out to dinner and I'll say... You're just like a woman. And you don't take it personally.
No, I don't.
You don't take it personally.
Yeah. You should do.
No.
You don't say, what do you mean?
Well, I know exactly what it means.
He dresses like a woman.
In the old days, he would have, you know, thrown a nut in or have a little punch up. And the worst that happens now is I bite him once in a while.
Yeah, he's got it coming.
Bite right here.
Doesn't break the skin.
It's the fleshy bit. It makes a point without breaking the skin.
Ah.
Yeah.
So answering the other question was basically, the work of my solos, it goes on and on. It's a lifelong thing.
It's rather like Lick My Love Pump, isn't it? It's just lifelong.
Yeah.
You're never going to get it right.
Well, no, but you can't ever get it right.
No.
It's not the point to get it right.
No, wouldn't be. Yeah. Mm.
Okay, Terry, thank you very much for the call. And we have Eric from Lafayette, Louisiana. Eric, what is your question for Spinal Tap?
Hey, guys, great to see you out with another album, and I hope to see you on tour before long.
You will. Great, Eric.
Look, I became a fan of yours in the late 60s, and Listen to the Flower People was a song that just kind of brought me to you guys.
Oh.
And I was wondering what you guys think of that song when you listen to it today, and how you think your views on music and the message in your music has changed from the 60s to the 90s.
Wow.
Well, we were a bit naive then, but not wrong, really. I mean, there's a piece on our new album called Rainy Day Sun, which was originally the B-side of Listen to the Flower People.
67,
yeah. And it really is, all that stuff really still rings true. I wish it were. I wish life were that simple.
Yeah.
Maybe someday it will be.
It used to be you'd walk out on the streets in white face, wearing clown shoes and dreaming of a time long ago when elephants and little worms were friends.
Did this really happen?
Did you do this?
What?
Did you do this?
Well, yeah.
White face?
Well, you know, if a little worm was to greet an elephant, he'd say, hello, you're so large, and he'd say, and you're the little one.
Okay. Thank you very much, Eric, for that phone call. We have just about enough time for one more call.
Let's not
Adam
let Eric
is
call
calling
again.
From yeah, New Eric's Rochelle, yeah. New York. Adam, what's Adam. Your question? I think you'll be our final caller.
All right, how are you guys doing?
Hello, Adam.
Hey, Adam, how are you?
Yeah, this question is for Derek.
Yeah.
I was wondering, guys, if Derek, if you on tour lately, have been having any problems getting through the metal detectors at airports?
No, no. For one thing, it's I want to take this opportunity to make clear it's a zucchini, not a cucumber.
Tell him why, though.
Well, because a cucumber, if you examine the skin of it, it's all pimply, and it defeats the purpose you're trying to communicate.
Which is being attractive.
Being attractive. It makes people worried, and they go, oh, it looks
concerned,
like you should
yeah.
see professional help.
Yeah.
But in terms of the wrapping itself, now there's a composite material which was developed for the stealth bomber, which evades radar and metal detectors, so you just shoot right through now.
So to speak.
That's good news.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, Spinal Tap, you are back. It astounds me. You're in a good way, and I'm happy about it.
You must still be feeling
on top of the world right now.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, slightly to the right of the top of the world, really.
What? Yeah.
Slightly to the right of the top of the world, and just down
yeah.
a bit.
Oh well, so you still have some place to go. You can.
That's right. Yeah.
That's right.
I wanted to show that you have the official 1992 Spinal Tap calendar.
Yeah.
That was a mistake.
It was a mistake.
But,
yeah.
That's a shipping.
It was supposed to be
which
the
of course is
calendar,
a colander.
Yeah.
It was more of a colander. Yeah.
Our record company.
If you read the slip in there, it apologizes and it says, you know, next year we'll try for the calendar, you know, if the boys are still together.
But they're doing a great job. They've even issued the album on 8-track.
Yeah, the 8-track is available.
But nobody has 8-tracks anymore.
No, that's not true.
A few
No, there are people
no.
who have it.
Yeah.
No, they take them out of their car, they stick them in the garage, and they'll get to them sometime.
Yeah. That's it's big in the Latino market.
And you have to be sensitive to those
that's right.
who might want to. Well,
whoever
thank you.
Wants to buy it can buy it now.
That's right.
That's the idea.
Thank you
thank
so
you.
Much for being
thank
on Rockline
nice
on MTV. It was great to see you again. Spinal Tap.
Yes.
This is it. That's it for this edition. Next week we'll be here with Ugly Kid Joe, and that's what's going on. Be with us then.
When do we get our tapes?
Take it. You'll also see two world premiere videos, Rusty Cage from Soundgarden and one from us called Bitch School. Be there. Feminist welcome.
Now, who do you suppose we are?
Hey!
Well, we are Spinal Tap. My name is David St. Hubbins. To my immediate left, Mr. Nigel Tufnel, lead guitar.
Hello.
To his immediate left and my non-immediate left, Mr. Derek Smalls on a
Yeah!
We are guest hosts tonight on Headbangers Ball.
That's not it.
We'll do the head, you do the banging. Now, on the way tonight...
Who does the balling?
We'll cover that later.
Right.
On the way tonight, classic videos from some rock and roll heavy hitters like whom? Aerosmith, like Kiss, and like the Scorps. Scorpions, that's right. Plus, world premieres from our personal friends, Soundgarden,
yes.
and us. Their personal friends, Spinal Tap.
Yeah.
That's right.
Later on in the show, you'll see debuts from Roxy Blue, Six Toxic...
Slick Toxic?
No, it's Slick Toxic.
It's Slick Toxic, they're good.
And Asphalt Ballet.
No, they're not.
And right now, this is the countdown to the ball.
Uh-oh, falling to the bottom of the chart. Here's Ozzy Osbourne at number 10 from the original soundtrack album of MAME. MAME, I'm coming home.
It's Mama.
I'm coming home.
Slack, what you give on the official countdown to the ball. We, of course, are Spinal Tap. You remember us? We'll be back with the top 7 videos of Countdown to the Ball, including a classic tune from Aerosmith. So don't move, don't go away, stay here, all that.
Welcome back to the Countdown to the Ball. We're Spinal Tap.
We're over here.
Oh!
Yeah, you've got to talk over there,
thanks.
Yeah.
Thanks, boys.
All right.
Welcome back to the Countdown to the Ball. I'm Derek Smalls. Here's Nigel. Here's David. We're Spinal Tap. Next hour, you'll see two world premieres, one from Soundgarden called Rusty Cage, and one from us. It's our new video. It's called Bitch School.
Right.
If you ever want to see it again,
call MTV.
Call MTV.
Yeah.
Dial 1-800-MTV or read my lips.
And keep trying. Now, here's number 7 down from 3 last week. It's Aerosmith from MTV's 10th anniversary with Dream On.
Yeah!
Right now, that's, of course, with Edward Van Halen.
Yeah.
Of genius fame. We, of course, are Spinal Tap still.
Yeah.
Of sub-genius fame.
Yeah.
Always will be. Now, right after the break, we'll roll out the top 4 videos on the countdown to the ball. So stay tuned. You have no choice.
Hey.
Well, that's us, isn't it?
Yeah.
Welcome back to the countdown to the ball. We've our Spinal Tap still.
That's right.
Yeah.
And when the clock strikes midnight, watch out for world premieres from our new album, Break Like the Wind, and from Soundgarden's highly recommended Bad Motor Finger album.
Right now, here's Pearl Jam with a number 4 video on the countdown to the ball. This is Alive.
Completely Alive.
Aye.
That was Queensryche's Anybody Listening. Last week, they were number 1. But fewer people are listening. So coming up after the break, you'll see the band who kicked them out of the number 1 spot. Stay tuned and find out the answer to the mystery, who it is.
I bet they're from Seattle too.
Look, I'm on the edge of my seat because we're just about at the end of our countdown to the ball.
In just minutes, when the clock strikes 12, the Headbangers Ball begins and you'll see for the first time anywhere in the world premiere of our brand new video,
Bitch School!
I'd like to say that with you next time.
Bitch School!
Bitch School!
Bitch School!
Right now it's time for the number 1 video on the countdown to the ball. Here's Ugly Kid Joe from MTV's Spring Break 92. We were there with Everything About You.
Do it.
That was the number 1 video on the countdown to the ball, Ugly Kid Joe from MTV's Spring Break 92.
Right now, it's time for the Headbangers Ball to begin.
Prepare. That's better.
Right now.
Yeah, you're ready
coming
to ball.
Up in the next 2 hours, the latest from Def Leppard, Skid Row and Body Count. Classics from Kiss and Scorpions, and the world premiere of Rusty Cage from Soundgarden.
Before, well, there's one other world premiere, yeah.
Yeah. Before we get to all that, here's a world premiere from us! From our forthcoming, and actually fifth coming, because it's out already, album, Break Like the Wind. Just happened to have the CD right here in my hand.
Show it to camera too.
I did.
Yeah.
Here's a world premiere. Our first video is called
Bitch School!
Did you like that? Did you like Bitch School?
Oh, yeah.
Would you like to hear it again? Well, all you got to do is dial 1-800-DIAL-MTV. It'll be busy for a while, but keep trying, you know.
Or just ask the operator how to call MTV, should tell you.
Yeah.
Because it's from our new album, Break Like the Wind. This is the vinyl picture disc.
And that over there, that's the very special 8-track, a limited edition.
And this is our environmentally
correct
package.
And right here, this is our extra long box. It's got over 50% more recyclable material, and that's to help Mother Earth and our sales at the same time. Yeah, tilting down this way.
Down.
Look at those builds.
There's more great videos coming up. Let's now check out a new one from Def Leppard in the studio for 3 years.
Yeah.
Bloody hell, let's get rocked!
Go, Nigel, go.
Hello. We'll be back with Old Kiss and the new video from King's X.
You're scaring them, you're scaring them.
It's a definite improvement.
You'll notice the difference. Now, coming up, Guns N' Roses live from the Ritz and Body Count featuring Ice-T. There goes the neighborhood.
Yeah, right now, here's Kissed with Rock and Roll All Night. Go. Because after the break, we've got debuts from Asphalt Ballet, Roxy Blue, Slip Toxic, and Love Hate.
Plus, the world premiere of Rusty Cage from our mates from Seattle, Soundgarden.
Hello, Chris.
Could I get less current running through this chair, please?
Hi,
just for
I'm
a
less,
short time.
I'm less current.
Yeah, now, right now. Oh, sorry, I didn't know you were ad-libbing.
Yeah.
And now I'll just read this. Right now, here's your chance to pick one of the videos you will see tonight. Now check out a piece of this video from Shotgun Messiah and call us up to tell us to crank it or yank it. Take a look. Take a
The choice is yours. It really wasn't loud enough in the studio for us to tell, but should we crank Heartbreak Boulevard or yank it?
It's up to
the
you.
The number to call is 1-900-370-0100, and each call costs you 50 cents. The phone lines will only be open for a short time, so call now. You'll see the results next hour when we crank or yank Shotgun Messiah's Heartbreak Boulevard.
Now here's David to say this.
Listen. Some friends of ours, Chris and Company from Seattle, Washington, a world premiere from Soundgarden, Rusty Cage.
Yeah!
Oh, up next, a Youngbloods block. And you'll see three brand new videos from some younger bands like Slick Toxic, Asphalt Ballet.
But here's the first debut, Roxy Blue. With good advice for everyone, Rob the Cradle!
That was a debut of Tuesday Rain from Asphalt Ballet. We are Spinal Tap, Nigel Tufnel.
Derek Small.
David St. Hubbins.
Yeah. Coming up, we've got the results from tonight's Crank or Yank, Shotgun Messiah's Heartbreak Boulevard.
But first, while you're dialing, or while you're waiting for the results of dialing, here's a video from our past. Unlike Bitch School, our new video, which you can see on MTV by dialing 1-800-DIAL-MTV, here's our old classic, Hello!
Dun, 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 dun.
Yeah, that was Guns N' Roses live from the Ritz in New York City, which is not very ritzy after all. And Slash from Guns N' Roses, along with Joe Satriani, Jeff Beck, Steve Lukather,
Dweezil Zappa.
Dweezil Zappa and the lovely Cher, all guests on... What album would that be on? Break the Wind.
Spinal Tap.
And speaking of breaks...
Yeah, coming up after the break, three debuts from Roxy Blue, Slick Toxic and Asphalt Ballet.
That's three.
So stick around and see what happens.
Why not?
That's all. Really is. It's still incredibly uncomfortable. We're Spinal Tap, tonight's guest host on the Headbangers Ball. Now it's time for the results of Crank or Yank. As you can see from the percentages on the screen, you guys decided to crank Shotgun Messiah. Congratulations, Messiah!
Here it is, Shotgun Messiah, Heartbreak Boulevard.
For you.
Stick around for a debut from Love Hate and Quicksand Jesus from Skid Row.
They keep getting on that bus, but they never go anywhere, you notice that?
Well, neither do we.
Oh, we are Spinal Tap.
We're still here.
At the Headbangers Ball. I'm David.
Derek.
And I'm Nigel.
And we're going on tour in America.
That's right.
Yes.
We might be right in your very own city. Starting in May, we're going to be going all over this country and slopping over into some other countries as well in the European area.
Check your local listings in your newspapers and see where we are.
Yeah.
We'll do the same.
For you?
Yeah.
Now here's Classic Scorpions, Rock You Like a Hurricane.
No, I was just looking at the monitor. It looked really nice.
You do.
That was a debut from Love Hate. Happy hour.
He looks right pretty for this time of day.
Yeah, I do.
If you want to write to the Headbangers Ball, go to school and spend a few years, then send your letters to this address, Headbangers Ball, care of MTV Networks, 1515 Broadway, 24th floor, New York, New York, 10036.
We'll be right back after this, so stick around.
Oh. I don't know. Well, it's been quite a night so far, hasn't
it? We've had so much bloody fun, we hate to leave, but it's almost time to say goodbye, because here's the last video for the night. Who is it?
Skid Row, with Quicksand Jesus.
Jesus. I've had such a good time tonight.
Me too.
It's almost illegal.
Yeah.
And next week on the ball, Ricky will be back. You'll like the new look. There might be a slight snapping sound when he speaks, but you'll get used to it.
We're Spinal Tap. Our new album is called Break Like the Wind. And if you want to see our new video, Bitch School, give the lot at MTV a call, ring them up, say, where's the vid?
Yeah.
Members of Roxy Blue and Motor Psycho will be stopping by.
Next week.
Yeah.
So we're gone, aren't we?
We've got to go.
We've got to bring Nancy on stage.
Come on, Nancy.
Come on, Eva. This whole show possible.
Come on, Eva. Come on, get over here.
Please, where's she going?
Please, come over here. This is Eva, she's the belle of the ball. Nancy's hiding, and here she is.
I got her.
Tie her to the tracks.
Goodbye.
Tie her to the tracks, Del, come on.
Goodbye.
Tie her to the tracks.
Here she is.
They're not happy about this. You know, you'd think they would be.
Yeah, you've been toying with this stuff for too long.
Women love this kind of thing.
Now it's getting all too real, isn't it?